we are talking about the person.
Mbulala imuntu yesh.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Is there anyone who's ready to read the Bible for me?
Mikona wamkalela kumkahla ribona.
Is there anyone who's ready to read the Bible for me?
Nakata shala ritra yini rashiku.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Amen. When we talk about the word of God, we are talking about the person.
Mbulala imuntu yesh.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we read in the book of John chapter 1,
loko mhlaka buka yona chapter 1,
the Bible says,
Bible le sona,
in the beginning there was the word.
Emasunga kuna rito.
There was no Bible.
Akari na Bible.
But there was the word.
Akuri na rito.
And the word was with God.
Rito le arna shikwemu.
And the word was God.
Rito le arna shikwemu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So who is the word of God?
Shana man rito le shikwemu.
When you check in verse number 2,
loko mhlaka verse number 2,
the Bible says,
Bible le,
he was with God in the beginning.
Yiri arna shikwemu masungule.
And everything was created through him.
Shana man rito le shikwemu.
So meaning that the word of God is a person.
Leso sokuru rito le shikwemu.
Because the Bible says he.
Yikuba Bible yiri he.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Let's come on.
And who is this person?
Shana man mulu.
It is Jesus Christ himself.
Yesu Kristu yesh.
Because everything was created through Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go to the book of Romans chapter number 5.
Romans chapter number 5.
Verse number 17.
Verse number 17. Over sa kuti nyoko.
I believe that today we're going to learn one or two things.
My God, that the Lord is my God.
Romans, Roma is stronger. Chapter 5, verse number 17. The book of Romans.
For if by the one man's offense.
Okay, by one man's offense. Uh-huh,
death reigned.
Uh-huh,
through the one, much more those who receive abundance of grace.
Okay.
And of the gift of righteousness.
And the gift, listen to this, and the gift of righteousness. And the gift of righteousness. And the gift of righteousness. So it means that righteousness is a gift. It means that the righteousness is a gift. Hallelujah. Continue reading.
The gift of righteousness will reign in the life through the one Jesus Christ.
Okay.
Therefore,
verse number 18. Huh? So through one man's offense,
judgment
came to all men. It means everyone was judged because of one man. So everyone became a sinner because of one man. Because of one man. It's not because you lied. It's not because you did this and this and that. But it was because of one man.
Amen.
Continue reading.
As through one man's offense,
okay,
judgment came to all men.
So judgment came to all men because of one man.
Resulting in condemnation.
Okay.
Even so,
okay,
through one man's righteous act,
okay,
the free gift came to all men.
Okay.
Resulting in justification of life.
Wow. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So here Paul is telling the church that by one man, all of us became sinners. All of us became sinners. Not because you did something. It's because of one man, Adam. That's why you're called a sinner. So sin is a nature, it's not an act. It is the nature of the first Adam.
Amen.
So when the first Adam, was judged, all men were judged. Even a newborn baby in the hospital is a sinner. But the moment they know about Christ, they become righteous. Not because the baby did something. Because of Christ.
Amen.
Because of the works of Christ. Because of the cross. Are we hearing this?
Amen.
Many people,
but not that,
they base the righteousness on works. They think they can be righteous because they can do good. And this is the righteousness of the law. In the Old Testament, you have to do something in order to be righteous. In the New Testament, We have to acknowledge the works of Jesus. And we have an access of righteousness.
Amen.
So we are made righteous because of Christ, not because we can do this. Hallelujah.
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 You must understand something about the cross. Okay, my sister, can you open the book of Romans chapter 3, verse number 28?
Verse 28.
We are not under the law, right?
I last now.
Do you believe on that thing? Do we read the Bible? Do we read the Bible?
Amen.
Sure, we read the Bible.
Shanaka has a Bible.
Okay, let's go to the scriptures. Chapter 3 of Romans, verse number 28.
Left.
Okay, what?
Truth is justified by faith.
A man is justified by what?
By faith.
By faith, eh?
Apart from the deeds of the law.
Oh, I'm just talking about this one. We didn't hear that.
Amen.
A man is made. A man is justified by faith. Apart from the law. Apart from the law. Because the law says I have to do this in order to be righteous. You condemn yourself. You have to do this in order for God to accept you. This is the mindset that many people they have. Whereas you are made righteous by faith. Apart from the law. Did the church all believe in the word? Before we read it, I want you to understand something about the book of Genesis. When we preach the word of God, when we teach the word of God, we teach the word of God in three dimensions. We teach in translation, and we teach in interpretation, and we teach in revelation. Translation is bound to one word. It's bound to one, it has one meaning. When I translate the word of God, it means that
there's
got one meaning and you're
going
to understand it. That's translation. When I say water, so it's water in translation. But when it comes to interpretation, when I say water, I mean the word of God. Water can mean the word of God. Remember the book of Acts chapter number 5. It says that we have been cleansed by the worship of the word of God.
Come on.
The word of God. Not only that, water represents the Holy Spirit. Water represents nations.
Come on.
This is the realm of interpretation. So when we go from interpretation, we come to revelation. Please clap the hands. How can these clap the hands? So this is interpretation. If we don't know how to interpret
Genesis,
we'll be confused. So we're going to the book of Genesis. The book of Genesis is full of figures of speech. It's full of symbols. It means that we have to do a lot of interpretation. We're going to have the revelation. And you begin to understand Christ in the book of Genesis.
Yes,
amen.
I hope you got the point.
Now some of
the motivational speakers.
The motivational speakers.
They walk in the realm of translation.
What about translation?
It's not interpretation and revelation.
I was going to go
Revelation comes by the Spirit. And interpretation, it comes also by the Spirit. So the things of God is all about the Spirit.
See,
what you have to do is to be flexible. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that's why spiritual things we interpret them. We don't translate them. That's why even dreams, we don't translate what we interpret. I like to give an example by a car. You can
feel
yourself driving a car.
But
that doesn't mean that you don't drive a car. That might mean a ministry. So we need the Spirit of God to interpret it. So it's about the interpretation. The book of Genesis. Then we're gonna flow in the Spirit. Chapter 3, verse number 14. I'm blessed. I'm not gonna take long.
So the Lord God said, Serpent, because you have done this, you are cursed more than all cattle, and more than every beast of the field. On your belly you shall go.
On your what?
On your belly.
On your what? Listen to what the Bible says.
It says of people
at least that you shall go on your belly.
You don't affirm a mockery.
And many people they thought maybe a snake it had legs and it also had arms. When the Bible said that you're gonna walk with your belly, God was saying that you're gonna reign in the flesh. Because a man is made out of the dust. The enemy is given, he's given the permission to
walk in the flesh.
That's why in the flesh is the territory of the devil.
Yo, mama.
Come on!
You will never defeat the devil in the flesh. It's like when you say that you want to change.
No,
by your mind and by your power. By the flesh, you can't. It is the territory of the devil.
Come on.
You need the word of God, which is the word of so when the Spirit and the Word come together, God begins to mold us. God begins to build us. God begins to walk us into the image of
God. Come on.
So this is what God was saying. The enemy is given the permission to walk in the flesh. We have to what? Spiritual minded. Because he knows that in the flesh, it's the territory of the devil. Actually, when you want to understand your position in
Christ,
master the book of Romans. The book which we are reading talks much about the law and it talks about righteousness. And it says that faith comes by hearing. Not hearing about the issues of the word of God. So when you hear the word of God, this is how faith is formed. Attack of the book of Romans, chapter number 10, verse 17. So in the book of Romans, chapter number 8, Paul is going deeper understanding the
Spirit. So Paul is
going deeper understanding
the Spirit.
That you must not be
carnal
minded. We refuse to be spiritual.
Aye, let me go on one much more.
And that's what God is talking about. And in chapter number 8 in the book of Romans.
Well,
in the book of Romans chapter 8, he said, those who are led by the Spirit, these ones, they are the sons of God. This weapon is going deeper about the
Spirit.
Okay. On your belly shall you go.
Okay, with your belly shall go.
You said this one is raining in the flesh.
Okay, what is it?
You shall eat of the dust.
You shall eat of the dust,
all the days of your life.
Okay.
And I will put enmity.
It
means I will make enmity between the two of you.
Okay. Continue reading.
Didn't
hear that. Huh? Between what?
Between you and the woman.
So between you and the woman.
Let's get that one on our
get this again.
You don't understand.
When you talk about the woman,
look, we blow like what's up?
We talk about the church.
You blow like correct.
You are interpreting the scriptures.
So
when you interpret the woman,
look, we shall
look what's up the church.
Oh, we better correct.
Continue reading.
Between.
There is enmity between the church and the devil.
Come on.
There is enmity
between
the church and the devil. That's why we're here to fellowship at some point.
That's why you're like that.
Okay, continue reading.
And your
seed
and
your seed. So there is the enmity between the seed of a woman. The story of Goliath and David. Now listen to this very carefully.
This
Listen to this very carefully. Now, David is going to face Goliath.
David is going to Goliath.
And the Goliath is like the seed.
Goliath is going to be
the one. The seed of the serpent. The seed of the Satan. And David is from the seed of a woman.
David is going to be the one.
So, what we have read in chapter number 3. There is something very powerful there. Now, listen unto this. David says, I am coming unto you in the name of
God.
It was not a physical fight, but it was a spiritual fight.
So
it was highly impossible for David for David to defeat Goliath. So before the word David, he went into the river.
Before David,
and he picked the 5 stones. And when he picked the 5 stones, the
Bible
said that he took 1 stone. And who is the stone in the
Bible?
See in the scriptures, the Bible says that Jesus is the
Jesus.
So, meaning that David was using the word of God
fighting
against Goliath. So, it means that if we don't have the word of God, we
will never
defeat the enemy. So,
that's why
the book of Ephesians, chapter number 6, talk about the power of God.
Hallelujah. Amen.
And the Son of God has put all the armor of God.